Good morning, my dear students. Yesterday we have started the chapter, the last leaf. Okay. So yesterday I have told you that there were basically three main characters in that chapter. It was Sue, it was Jonsi, and it was Behrman. Up to yesterday, we have come to know that Sue and Jonsi, they both were very good friends. Jonsi fell ill and she was suffering with pneumonia, but she has made up one of the wrong assumption in her mind. What was that assumption? The assumption was that outside her window there was one of the ivy creeper. So whenever she was in her bed, she was looking outside continuously, and she saw that from that ivy creeper the leaves were falling down. See, it was season of autumn, so that's why leaves were falling down. It was natural, but she has made up her mind that by falling off the leaves from that tree, her condition was also go down and down, and when only one leaf would be left on that tree, so then it would be her last day and she would be dying. So such kind of assumption got developed in her mind. So her friend Sue, she did so much for her. She consoled her, she took care of her. But Jonsi, she was not able to change her mind. So when doctor gave this thing that no medicine can cure her because she has to come out of that thought, so it was not possible at all. So after that, they found one solution. They found that one of the neighbor named Behrman, he was ready to help them. So how did he help them? This thing we are going to read today. So I'm going to share screen with you. Let's start reading from there. So up to that we have read yesterday, I think from this Sue sat on Jonsi's bed. We have read this paragraph. All right, said Jonsi. Promise not to look out of the window. So when painting was going on, she promised that during that time she would not see outside. This promise was made by Jonsi to Sue. Okay. So all right. After that, Jonsi said that she really wanted to see the last leaf falling. It was her wish. So up to that we have read. Okay. So who is going to read further from this paragraph? All right. Who is going to read? Raise your hand, those who are going to read. Okay, I'll just give duty to Ashmeet. Ashmeet, you read from this. All right, said Jonsi.
All right, said Jonsi. Finish your painting, for I want to see the last leaf fall. I am tired of waiting. I have to die. So let me go away peacefully, like one of those poor, tired leaves. Try to sleep, said Sue. I have to paint an old miner. I will call Behram up to be my model. Sue rushed down. Behram lived on the ground floor. He was a 60-year-old painter. His lifelong dream was to paint a masterpiece, but that had remained a dream. Sue poured out. Where is it?
Sue poured out her worries
to Behram. She told her how Jonsi was convicted that she would die when the last leaf fall. Is she stupid? Asked Behram. How can she be so foolish? She is running a high temperature, complained Sue. She refuses to eat or drink, and that worries me a lot. I will come with you to see Jonsi, Behram said. They all tinted into the room. Jonsi was sleeping. Sue drew
the curtains together. What happened? You are not having book, you are reading from screen. Okay, up to that I just explained what happens. Okay, so we have come to know. So Jhansi agreed. She said, okay, you finish your painting, because she was so desperate to see last leaf falling. Okay, she was very much tired of waiting, because now she was saying that she really wants to die. So she said, okay, let me go away. Let me go away from there peacefully. Okay, like one of those poor tired leaves. As tired leaves have fallen down, their life is no more now. So in the same way, she also wanted to die. Okay, so Sue consoled her that you try to sleep, because I have to paint an old miner. Okay, so she said, I'm going to call Behmann to be my model, because he would be his he would be her model. Okay, he would be sitting and she was going to paint a pic of an old miner. So Sue rushed down. Okay, Behmann was living on ground floor. Okay, and what was the age of that person? His age was 65 years old. 65 years. Okay, he was 65 years old. Okay, and what was his dream? Dream of Behmann was that he wanted to paint a masterpiece, but that really remained his dream only. Okay, so Sue told each and everything to Behmann about Jhansi's condition. So she told that how Jhansi was very much convinced that she would die when the last leaf would fall. Okay, so Behmann, he got very much surprised and he said, okay, is she you can say stupid? How can she be so foolish? Okay, because she was suffering with a high fever. Okay, and she was refusing to eat also, she was refusing to drink also, and that was causing a lot of worry to her friend Sue. Okay, so Behmann said, okay, he was agreed to help Jhansi. Okay, so they tiptoed means they went into her room secretly. So write down the meaning of tiptoed. Tiptoe means you can say walked slowly. Okay, so bachche write down these difficult word meanings. Tiptoe. Okay, so they walked slowly into the room. Jhansi at that time she was sleeping. Okay, so Sue, what did she do? She drew the curtains and she went to the they both went to the next room. Okay, they were peeping out. Peeping out means they were just looking inside through the window, and they were so surprised that there was only one leaf on the creeper, and it was raining so heavily. Very cold wind was blowing, and it was seeming as the last leaf was also about to fall. Okay, so it was raining heavily. Read from there. Who is going to read? Who is going to read from there? Divyanshi, you will be able to read? Divyanshi.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, start reading.
It was raining heavily and icy cold wind was blowing. It seemed as though the leaf would fall any minute now. Behmann did not say a word. He went back to his room. Jhansi woke up next morning. In a feeble voice, she asked Sue to draw the curtains. Sue was nervous. She drew back the curtains very reluctantly. Oh, Sue exclaimed as she looked at the winekeeper. Look, there is still one leaf on the keeper. It looks quite green and healthy. In spite of storm and fierce winds, it didn't fall. I heard the wind last night, said Jhansi. I thought it would have fallen. It will surely fall today. Then I'll die. You won't die, said Sue energetically. You have to live for your friends. What would happen to me if you die? Jhansi smiled weakly and closed her eyes. After every hour, she would look out of the window and find the leaves still there. It seemed to be clingy to the keep, creeper. In the evening, there was another storm, but the leaf didn't fall. Jhansi lay for a long time looking at the leaf. Then she called out to Sue. I have been a bad girl. You have looked after so lovingly and I haven't cooperated with you. I have been... ma'am, screen aage kar do. I have not cooperated with you. I have been depressed and gloomy. The last leaf has shown me how wicked I have been. I have realized that it is a sin. I want to die.
Okay. It means people are not having book when you are reading. You should have books. Only then you'll be able to understand the text because you have to write down the meanings of difficult words also. Okay. So what happened? They went into her room secretly. Jhansi was sleeping at that time. She drew the curtains and they went to the next room. They looked through the window that there was only one leaf. Okay. And very harsh wind was blowing on. And it was seeming that the last leaf would fall any minute. Okay. But Behrman did not say a word. He went back to his room. Okay. So Jhansi got up next morning in a very feeble voice. What is the meaning of feeble? Can anybody tell me? What is the meaning of feeble?
Weak and soft.
Yes. Feeble means weak. In a very weak voice, in a very weak voice, she asked Sue, please draw the curtains. Okay. So Sue was very much nervous. Okay. So she drew the curtains. But she drew it very reluctantly. Reluctantly means with lots of hesitation. Okay? Because she was not sure that what would have happened to that leaf. So with lots of hesitation, she, you can say, बच्चे राइट डाउन द मीनिंग्स ऑफ डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स आई एम टाइपिंग हियर फॉर यू सो विद लॉट्स ऑफ हेसिटेशन शी ड्रू द कर्टन्स बैक एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स व्हाट हैपेंड ओ सू एक्सक्लेम्ड ओ शी लुक्ड एट द वाइन पेपर. Look, there is still one leaf. So Sue said with confidence, now see that there is still one leaf on the creeper. And this leaf was looking so green. It was so looking healthy. Healthy means it was in proper condition. It has not become yellow in color. Okay, with the passage of time. Even the there was a heavy storm. Fierce winds were going on. Okay, fierce means, what is the meaning of fierce? It means very much violent. So write down the meaning of fierce, very much violent. Bachche, you have to write down these meanings for yourself. If you write down, it will be easy for you to understand the text. So write down bachche meanings also. So fierce means very much violent. Okay. So Jhansi said, yes, I heard the wind last night. It was blowing so harshly. So I thought that this leaf would have fallen. Okay. And now she says, it will surely fall today and then definitely I will die. So Sue spoke very energetic with lots of enthusiasm, with lots of energy. She said, no, you will not die because you have to live for your friends. Okay. Sue said that what would happen to me if you die? So such kind of consolation was given by Sue to Jhansi, and she wanted that her friend should not think about such kind of assumption. She should come out from such things. Okay. So Jhansi was smiling, but she was smiling so weakly and she closed her eyes. After every hour, she was looking out of the window and she was finding still the leaf was there or not. And it was seeming that it was clinging to the creeper. What is the meaning of clinging? What is the meaning of clinging? Can anybody tell me? Clinging means that something was like something that it was, you can say hold. It was folded tightly. So it was folded so tightly to the creeper, it was seeming like that. So what happened in the evening? There is a now twist in the story. There is a, you can say, suspense in the story. So basically what happened in the evening? So who is going to read about this? What happened in the evening? Okay, Divya, you read.
Yes, ma'am. Sue hugged Johnsy. Then she gave her lots of hot soup.
In the evening, there was another storm.
Yes, ma'am. 2 seconds.
I have explained up to clinging to the creeper. Afterwards,
ma'am. In the evening, there was another storm, but the leaf did not fall. Johnsy lay for a long time looking at the leaf. Then she called out to Sue. I have been a bad girl. You have looked after me so lovingly, and I have not cooperated with you. I have been depressed and gloomy. The last leaf has shown me how wicked I have been. I have realized that it is a sin to want to die. Sue hugged Johnsy. Then she gave her lots of hot soup and a mirror. Johnsy combed her hair and smiled brightly. In the afternoon, the doctor came. After examining his patient, he told Sue, Johnsy now has the will to live. I am confident she will recover soon. Now I must go downstairs and see Bherman. He is also suffering from pneumonia, but I am afraid there is no hope for him.
Now,
the
see,
next morning.
Wait. So what happened in evening? Okay, another storm came, but the leaf did not fall. So it was so strange that there was a heavy storm. Okay, heavy winds were blowing on, but leaves were not falling down. Okay, so Johnsy was in her bed for a very long time and she was looking at the leaf. Then she called Sue. Okay, so Johnsy, what did she admit? You'll be surprised to know. She considered herself a very bad girl because she was not behaving properly. She was not cooperating with her friend. She was in depression. She was feeling so gloomy. Gloomy, what is the meaning of gloomy? Gloomy means? Bachcha, write down its meaning. Gloomy means sad. Okay. So she was all the time, she was looking so sad. Okay. So the last leaf basically shown that how wicked I have been. So what is the meaning of wicked? Wicked means morally bad. According to this text, wicked means bad. So she considered herself, she was very much weak. She was, you can say, bad, behaving so bad. Okay. And she has realized this thing that it is really a sin to have such kind of wish that if you really want to die, it is really a sin. So when such kind of mentality she noticed, it means Johnsy has developed such kind of mentality. She realized her mistake that she was wrong on her side. So Sue hugged Johnsy. She gave her hot soup. She gave her mirror to look herself in the mirror. And after that, Johnsy combed her hair and she was smiling brightly. It means she had a ray of hope to live better life. Okay. So in afternoon when doctor examined her, okay, so he was confident now Johnsy would definitely recover very soon because she has now will to live. She has a desire to live. She has a will. Here, what is the meaning of will? Will here means desire. Now she has will to live. Will here means she has developed that desire to live. Okay. And now Bahman was very much confident that definitely she will be recovering soon. Okay. Now Bahman took a decision. Now, sorry, Sue took a decision that she should go downstairs and she should see Bahman. How is that? Because Bahman was also suffering from pneumonia. Okay. And doctor said now there is no hope for him. So it was so surprising that Jonsi started recovering, but on the other hand, there was no hope for Nemo. There was no hope for Bahman to be recovered. Okay. So next morning, what happened? Sue came and she was sitting on the beside of Jonsi's bed. Okay. She took hands of Jonsi in her hand. And what did she say? It is really surprising thing that what did she say in her ears? So who is going to read? Okay, Laksh Jairath, you read.
Yes. The next morning, Sue came and sat on Jonsi's bed. Taking Jonsi's hand in hers, she said, "I have something to tell you. Mr. Bahman died of pneumonia this morning. He was ill for only 2 days. The first day, the janitor found him on his bed. His clothes and shoes were wet and he was shivering. He had been out in that stormy night. Then they found a ladder and a lantern still lighted lying near his bed. There were also some brushes and green and yellow paints on the floor near the ladder. Jonsi, dear," said Sue, "look out of the window. Look at the ivy leaf. Haven't you wondered why it doesn't flutter when the wind blows? That's Bahman's masterpiece. He painted it in the night the last leaf fell."
Okay. So, bachche, write down the meanings of these two difficult words. Janitor. Janitor means a person who looks after. You can say it can be a caretaker. It can be a doorkeeper who looks after other. Okay. And there, we have come across another word, flutter. Flutter means to move with quick light movement. So, bachche, write down these meanings. Only then you'll be able to understand the text. Okay. So, Jonsi. Sue took Jonsi's hands in her and she said, "I just want to tell you something. What is that? Mr. Bahman, he died because of pneumonia this morning. And he was suffering with fever for last 2 days. The first day, one of the..." What happened? Who is that? You can keep yourself mute. Don't create such kind of chaos in the class. So the first day, the caretaker found him on his bed and caretaker found that clothes and shoes were completely wet and he was shivering badly. Okay. Why he was shivering badly? Because for the whole night, he was out in that stormy night. Isn't it surprising? Why he was all out in that stormy weather? Because they found that there was a ladder, there was a lantern, you can say, that gives us light, one instrument, okay? And it was still lighting, like lying near his bed. And there were some brushes, green and yellow paints on the floor near the ladder. Do you know what was that? So said Sue, "You just look out of the window. There was one of the ivy creeper, okay? So you are not surprised that why these leaves are not fluttering, why these leaves are not moving when the heavy wind was blowing on? Because this ivy creeper is basically Bahman's masterpiece. He painted it because all other leaves who are present on that ivy creeper, this whole of the ivy creeper was painted by Bahman. He was having a ladder. He was sitting on that ladder in that stormy night when it was raining so heavily. But during that, he was sitting on that ladder and throughout the whole night, he was painting it. And that's why the last leaf when the last leaf fell, when there was no leaf on that ivy paper, he was painting, and now see there are abundance of leaves on that ivy creeper. Okay, and those leaves were looking identical. They were looking so same as the previous one leaves on the creeper. So during that process, during that work, his masterpiece got ready, but he died because of that stormy weather, because of getting wet, because of getting drenched in that weather, and he was not able to survive. So in this way, Johnson's life was saved, but Behmen's life was no more. He was no more. Clear? Now let's discuss question answer. What is Johnson's illness? What can cure her? The medicine or the willingness to live? So all of you prepare this answer. I'm giving you 2 minutes to think over this answer, prepare your notes and get ready with this answer. And raise your hand. I want to see, you can say intelligent students, and I can ask this answer from any of the child. So you be ready with that. Hurry up, beta. Only one girl has raised her hand, that is Ashmeet Kaur. She knows the answer. What about others? Now only 2. Out of 31, only 4 participants are raising their hand. Isn't it surprising? Okay, Dhiren, you tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am. Johnsey's illness is pneumonia. Sue and Johnsey were the 2 young artists which shared a small flat, and they lived together. And Johnsey was suffering from pneumonia, and she would keep lying on her bed. But a surprising thing was that she didn't want it to live. She was counting the leaves as 12, 11, 10, then 9. And she one day informed Sue that she would die one day when the last leaf would fall. And the thing that can cure her is not the medicine, but is the willingness to live. As a person who doesn't have the will to live can't be cured even by medicine or even by prayers.
Good. Very good. You have added all the details in your answer. So very nicely you have written. Now Divyanshi beta, you tell me same answer. After Divyanshi, Arzu should be ready.
Johnsy was suffering from pneumonia. She wouldn't want to live, and it was very shockingly that she doesn't want to live. The only cure to the only medicine to cure her was the desire to live. She was counting the leaves on the tree, and she had set up her mind that as the leaves will fall off the tree, and then she will die. But there was no medicine to cure him, and this was the only medicine that the desire to live and the willingness to live.
Okay, good. Now Arzu, tell me same answer. After Arzu, Shivraj, you should be ready.
Johnsey was suffering from the disease pneumonia. Only the willingness to live could cure her. She had made up her mind that she was not going to get well. The doctor said that if she did not want to live, medicines would not help her.
Good. Now Shivraj, but elaborate this answer in detail. Okay, add some more points. Shivraj. Yes, Shivraj, you tell me this answer. Shivraj, are you here in my class?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me this answer, beta.
Okay, ma'am. And Johnsey was suffering from the disease named pneumonia, and she don't have any hope to live, but a doctor have told him she should have a hope to live, and
so bachche, now time is running out. I'm going to over your class, and this work I'm giving you as a homework. You go through this chapter thoroughly again, and only 4 questions are given. You frame these answers, and tomorrow you all should be very much eager, enthusiastic to give me answer. Put your efforts, frame good answer, put good vocabulary words. Grammatically, there should not be any error, okay? And you should be quite enthusiastic and eager to tell me the correct answer. I would be appreciating all those students who would be raising their hands in my class, okay, and would be giving me good quality answers, okay? So you have 1 day to prepare good answers. So give your best. Okay, bachche, thank you and have a nice day.